at this point, it's just kind of on our doctor's timeline. He's telling us where I'm at in the stage of recovery and how far out I am. So I guess for me at this point, it's my job to let him know that you know, I'm feeling good, I'm ready to go, so I can try and push that a little bit. So I'm doing my best, I promise.
When it comes to injuries, they often talk about the pain level on a scale of 1 to 10. When the injury happened, where was that at, and what's it like now?
Well, when the injury actually happened, I mean, middle of the play, a lot of adrenaline. Definitely knew there was something wrong, but I wasn't really thinking about it too much. Still, I wouldn't recommend trying it. Was not a very pleasant experience. The doctor wrestling around, trying to get it back into place, was probably worse than the initial injury as far as pain goes. But it was a zinger, man. Definitely felt it. You know, probably the worst pain was, you know, mentally and physically the next day, realizing, you know, the severity of what happened. You know, during the game, before everything tightened up, before the swelling set in and all that, you know, I was kind of like, you know, whatever, I'm going to kick this thing's ass and be back next week. But, you know, when I got up the next morning and my elbow was the size of a grapefruit, I kind of realized that that might not be something that I could physically do. Yeah, actually, when I left the field, I still had full range of motion, and I mean, it hurt, but I felt like I could go back into the game, is how it felt. Game was over, obviously, unfortunately, but no, it felt fine. But that was kind of the best it's felt since the injury. It's kind of went downhill from there. So. You're damn right. Yeah. Man, I'll tell you guys what, Andy Janovich he's one of the most, you know, humble, hardworking, diligent individuals I've ever, you know, been around, had the pleasure of working with. That guy, he works hard on the field, off the field, academics, he's working every spare hour he has, he's working construction or doing something. And, you know, we've all known for such a long time that he's a great athlete, great football player, you know, and, you know, in practice he's knocking skulls every day like he's in the Super Bowl. And he's running routes, he's running like he's in the Olympics. It's amazing. But man, to see him finally get the opportunity to go out there and show what he can do, was pretty special for me. He's been a good friend of mine, and man, I'm happy for him. We've seen it over the last, you know, few years. That guy, he's never dropping footballs. If they throw him the ball, you know, once a game it was or whatever, he was catching it and he was doing his job, but it just seemed like the refs were never there. And man, on Saturday to see him get the ball and have success was awesome. I'm ecstatic for him.
Were you guys both former wrestlers, or was
that like school? Yeah, we were. We were both wrestlers. Andy was like a 2 or 3 time state champ, undefeated a few years. Andy was a mean son of a gun out there. He's a good wrestler. So yeah, that's something we have in common. That's probably why we get along. We're former wrestlers, and we both like hunting and fishing and that kind of thing. So he's actually my roommate now. We get along pretty good. Oh, I would pin him in a millisecond. No, nobody tell him I said that, though. Definitely.